season, it's gratifying to see so many people here today, but we've got some great music, and I'm sure that's why you're here. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Ivan Miller, and I'm chairman of this series. And if anyone would like to get notification on the email of these programs in the future, you can fill out a little slip of paper on the desk and put your name and email, and I'll be happy to add you to our list. And these programs are open to the public. We do not sell tickets. It is supported solely by contributions from music lovers. I get no other subsidies except the generosity of people that appreciate this program. So I welcome all your participation. We take U.S. dollars, we take euros, and we'll take Confederate money. That would be worth more than a dollar. But anyway, enough said. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce to you the Vega Quartet.
Thank you. Thank you.
we're ready to begin the second half of the program with Brahms. Can someone, well, never mind. Will, would you like to come out and say a few words? Will Ransom, our pianist. Thank you, Adam. It is so wonderful to be back here playing for you. There are many reasons. This room is so special. It's like a sound box. And so the sound is so wonderful all the way back. I love playing here for that. You all, the audiences, are always so warm and inviting here. And that makes us play better as musicians as well, because we feel like we're getting something back from you as well. And I also love coming here because I feel like I'm coming home to my Jewish roots as well. So that's wonderful. I'm also delighted to be here today playing with some of my favorite musicians in the world, the Vega String Quartet, who are the first professional string quartet to ever be based in Atlanta. And they're really transforming the music education and performance experience all across the community. Delighted to have them here. If I could welcome out one by one, the cellist, Quang Wong. I'm especially delighted to welcome Libby, as she is known here, because it's her first time performing here at the synagogue, so we're delighted that she's here with us today as well. We are going to be playing this wonderful Brahms quintet for you. There's so much to say about Brahms and his music, but I wanted to limit it to two things that are particularly fascinating to me about this particular piece. Brahms had a number of obsessions in his life, as we all do, and one of them, of course, was the great love of his life, Clara Wieck Schumann, who was the wife of Robert Schumann, one of Brahms' great patrons and someone who supported him so much at the very beginning of his career. And without getting into all the drama about that amazing threesome between Clara, Johannes, and Robert, which was quite something, I'll just say that both Robert and then Johannes Brahms would put into their music Clara's name, calling her name in love. And in this piece particularly, oh, where's my wonderful patron? There she is. Please welcome Emma as well, a beautiful patron who has my score that I need to check. You'll hear in the second movement, which I think is purely a love song to Clara Schumann, and both Brahms and Schumann would quote in their music, would write in their music, either a two-note theme calling her name. Quite often it would be Clara. Or Robert Schumann would often write a five-note theme for the five notes of Clara. But in this piece, in the slow movement, Brahms is calling Clara's name so beautifully. And I hear him saying, Clara, how I love you. Of course, he didn't speak English, but you know. So you'll hear him singing his love to Clara throughout that slow movement. And one of the other big obsessions in Brahms' life, of course, was Beethoven. I mean, in any musician's life, I suppose. But Brahms really took this seriously. His very first piece, his Opus 1, was a piano sonata. And Beethoven's great Hammerklavier sonata, considered perhaps the greatest example of any sonata form piece, begins like this. And so Brahms' Opus 1 piano sonata begins. With exactly the same rhythm. Now in the scherzo of this particular quintet, he's showing his obsession with Beethoven as well, with the most famous of all Beethoven themes. You stop someone on the street who knows nothing about classical music and you say, Beethoven, they'll probably say, oh yeah!
And this is what Brahms does with that through the scherzo, with that rhythm.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.